Sunday, Christians gather to celebrate Christ's resurrection. But today, Christians gather around the world and greet each other on this day, saying, Christ is risen, and response is,
He is risen indeed.
Let's try that again. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Paul reminds us not only that Christ lives, but in Him we also are made alive. In our baptisms, we join with Him in His death, and as He rises from the dead to the glory of the Father, we also are given newness of life. We begin with our opening prayer. Almighty God, through Your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, You have overcome death and opened unto us the gate of everlasting life. We humbly beseech You, grant us Your Holy Spirit, that we may rule and govern us according to Your will. Graciously keep us in the true faith, defend us from all sin, and after this life, rise to eternal life through Your beloved Son, who lives and reigns with You and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Easter scripture reading is from Job 19, verses 23 through 27. Oh, that my words were written. Oh, that they were inscribed in a book, that they were engraved on a rock with an iron pen and lead forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and He shall stand at last on the earth. And after my skin is destroyed, this I know, that in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another, how my heart yearns within me. We join in our first hymn, hymn number 199, verses 1 and 2.